Good afternoon, everybody. It's great to see such a turnout to learn about colon cancer today and raise awareness of this preventable and treatable disease. I'm a medical oncologist at Columbia here, and the title of my talk is Colon and Rectal Cancer. How much of a problem is it really? I think everyone in this room knows that it's a big problem, but the goal of my talk today is to arm you with some information that you can share with friends and family to raise awareness of the problem of colon and rectal cancer in your community and in your social groups. So first, I'll talk about some basics. What is colon and rectal cancer, and how does colon and rectal cancer develop? Then I'll show you some charts and statistics about how many people are actually affected by colon and rectal cancer in the U.S. today. Then I'll talk about what determines prognosis in colon cancer. And finally, end with, are we making any progress against colon cancer? So what is colon and rectal cancer? Cancer in general is the uncontrolled growth of abnormal cells in one part of the body. And without treatment, cancer in one part of the body can spread to other organs in a process that we call metastasis. So this is a diagram of the colon here. And so colon cancer is cancer that starts anywhere inside the colon, and rectal cancer refers to cancer that begins in the last portion of the colon. How does colon cancer develop? This is a diagram of how we think colon cancer develops over time. Cells in the lining of the colon are constantly dying off and being replaced in a controlled and orderly fashion. And in the process of replicating themselves, these cells can acquire mutations. So you can see here that this is hyperproliferation. Sometimes these mutations can cause the cells to grow when there's no indication for them to grow. And so over time, these cells can grow into larger and larger polyps, which are shown here. These are still all benign. Now, over time, if one cell acquires enough mutations, it can turn into a cancerous cell that grows and takes over this polyp. So over here, these are the malignant tumors. And you can see that this white area, which is the cancer, has invaded into the colon wall. And if these aren't caught early enough, the cancer can invade into the colon wall, damage adjacent structures, and sometimes spread to other parts of the body. Now, we think that this occurs over a long period of time. We estimate it about 10 years, though it might be shorter, particularly in some people who have a genetic predisposition to colon cancer. So how many people are affected by colon cancer? In 2014 in the U.S., we estimate that 140,000 people will be diagnosed with colon or rectal cancer. Now, this is a chart showing you the most common diagnoses of cancer between men and women in the U.S. So as you can see, in men and women, the most common cancers that are diagnosed are prostate cancer and breast cancer. The second most common are lung cancer in both men and women. But third on the list is colon and rectal cancer. Together, colon and rectal cancer account for about 9% of all of the diagnoses of cancer that will be made in people this year in the U.S. How many people will die of colon cancer? In 2014, 50,000 people in the U.S. will die of colon or rectal cancer. If you look at this chart again, it's similar to the last chart, but it shows you the estimated number of deaths in men and women due to cancer in the U.S. this year. Now, this is lung cancer, even though it was the second most common, is the leading cause of cancer-related death in men and women. Prostate cancer is second on the list for men, and breast cancer for women. And third on the list, again, is colon and rectal cancer. So colon and rectal cancer account for 9% of the cancer-related deaths in the U.S. And what does this mean in plainer terms? This means that on average, 1 in 20 people will be diagnosed with colon cancer in their lifetime, and 1 in 50 people will die of colon cancer. That means that if you went to public school in the US where the class size is about 20 people, then the odds are that you'll have one person in your class who develops colon cancer at some point in their lifetime. So who gets colon cancer? We're going to have some great talks about genetics and the risk factors for colon cancer later this afternoon, but I just wanted to emphasize a few points. 90% of people who get colon cancer are over 50 years of age. Men are slightly more likely to get colon cancer than women, but it's by no means a disease that happens only in men. Family history can increase the risk of colon cancer, and environmental risk factors such as diet and exercise and lifestyle can also play a role in your risk for colon cancer. But what I want to emphasize here is that most people who develop colon cancer don't actually have a clear risk factor. And that's why it's important for everybody, whether you have risk factors or not, to get screened for colon cancer. What determines prognosis in colon cancer? As many of you know already, stage is the most important determinant of prognosis in colon cancer. So this is a diagram of the colon, and this is the inner lining of the colon, and this is a diagram of colon cancer at various stages. So stage zero is a stage where there are cancerous appearing cells in the colon, but they have not invaded into the colon wall at all. Stage one and stage two are when the cancer has invaded into the wall of the colon, but it hasn't yet reached the lymph nodes, which are depicted here. In stage three colon cancer, the cancer has spread into the adjacent lymph nodes. And finally, in stage four colon cancer, the cancer has involved lymph nodes or blood vessels, and through that pathway has spread to other organs. So how many people are diagnosed at each stage of colon cancer in the U.S.? This pie chart over here shows you what percentage of patients are diagnosed at each stage. So this 20% represents that a person who is diagnosed with colon cancer today has a 20% chance of being diagnosed at a stage four, so when they have metastatic disease. In stage four colon cancer, the likelihood of cure is not a curable stage of colon cancer, except in very select and special cases. 37% of people who are diagnosed with colon cancer will be diagnosed at a regional stage, meaning that there are lymph nodes involved. And 39% of patients with colon cancer will be diagnosed at a local stage, so stage one or two, when there are no lymph nodes involved. So the goal of screening for colon cancer is to move patients from this part of the pie where the likelihood of cure is very low to this part of the pie where the likelihood of cure is much higher. The likelihood of cure when you catch colon cancer at an early stage, so local stage, is 90% in 5 years. Are we making any progress against colon cancer? The short answer to this question is yes, absolutely we are. The number of new diagnoses of colon cancer has actually been decreasing since 1975. This chart shows you the number of cases per 100,000 persons in the US. This is the number of new cases of colon cancer, and this is the number of colon cancer-related deaths. So you can see that between 1975 and 1990, this curve was relatively flat. And over here, this is a horizontal line. You can see that since 1990, this rate of new cases or new diagnoses of colon cancer has been slowly decreasing. It's been decreasing about 3% per year in men and 2.3% per year in women. Along with this, the number of deaths related to colon cancer has also been decreasing steadily over this time. What this means is there are more than 1 million colon cancer survivors in the US today, many of whom are in this room right now. How has this progress been achieved? Colonoscopy and other forms of colon cancer screening have been a really important part of making progress against colon cancer. Because through colonoscopy, polyps are being found and removed before they become cancerous. So cancer is actually being prevented. Additionally, cancers, when they are diagnosed, are being detected at earlier and more curable stages. In addition to this, in the past 40 years, we've had many more improved surgical techniques and improved chemotherapy for colon cancer, which has also increased the likelihood of surviving and beating this disease. So I just wanted to review some of the most important take-home points from this talk. Colon cancer is one of the most common cancers in the U.S., and it will affect 1 in 20 of us in our lifetime. 90% of colon cancers will be found in people over 50 years of age. Colon cancer has a 90% cure rate in the early stages of the disease, but less than half of patients actually have their cancer diagnosed and detected at this stage. And finally, to end on a really positive note, rates of new diagnoses of colon cancer are decreasing in the U.S. every year due to colonoscopy and colon cancer screening. So colonoscopy not only detects cancer early, but can actually prevent cancer from developing by removing precancerous polyps. Thank you very much.